Well, the time has finally come to say goodbye. This is my current Apple iMac. It's almost 12 years old. Its software life ended a few years ago with the High Sierra version of the Mac OS, and the operating software inside cannot be further upgraded. This computer has gone through a lot of software upgrades over the years, but it has now reached its end. I'm already about 5 versions behind. This iMac computer is still working well, but the newer and latest applications now require a better machine to use all the new features available. So, thanks for all these years working with me. These are my new and old Mac side by side. There are several ways to set up a new Mac and to upload your saved data. One is by downloading from the cloud from your Apple account. Another is by the backups that were previously done by the old iMac. But the method that I will use is by direct connection from the old iMac to the new Mac Studio, just like a blood transfusion. Both Macs are connected by Ethernet cable to the same router on my home network, so the transfer should be very fast. Let's begin the process. As you might already know, Apple Macs can run two or more displays at the same time, and I would really love to keep my older iMac as a secondary monitor
over my dead body.
But I seem to be facing some objections over this. Also, my desk is a bit too small to have both monitors. So this should be how I would now set up my system, using my iPad as a secondary screen instead, as and when I need one. The beauty of the Apple ecosystem is that they can communicate seamlessly. All it takes is for me to tell my Mac I have my iPad on the left side or on the right side, and it will connect to it instinctively. So what can I do with the iPad? Well, it's like an extension to the main screen. For example, if I'm doing something in Photoshop or Premiere Pro, and I wanted to type some notes. Normally, we will bring up the Word program up front and Photoshop will automatically go to the back. But with the iPad, I can simply drag the whole Word program over to it and use it there while the Photoshop remains active on the main monitor. Or I can have all my assets like photos, graphics, other folders on the iPad at the side and bring it into Photoshop screen when I need those files. This will give me a lot of space to work, saves a lot of time searching, and increases the editing productivity. Another thing about the iPad is that I can use the iPad features like the Apple Pencil to draw on the apps where it is not possible to do that directly with the main monitor. One of the best things about my new Mac Studio is the internet connection speed. Most of us subscribe to the 1 gigabit internet connection from the local internet provider, be it Singtel, StarHub, or MyRepublic, or others. And with my old iMac, I used to get about 400 to 700 megabits connection at best of times. That was because my older iMac used the 1 gigabit Ethernet card. But now, with the new 10 gigabit card on the Mac Studio, I can consistently get about 900 plus megabits connection, which is very close to the promised 1 gigabit connection from the internet provider. As a comparison, look at this demo. Both my old and new Macs are connected by the same internet cable to the same home network router. Of course, there will be a slight loss as they share the same split cable, but you can still see the difference. Here's a word of advice if you have cable at home. Don't settle for the slow Wi-Fi speed. Use a cable connection. So thanks very much for watching my unboxing and setup, and do return to my channel if you like to see how I'm progressing with this new speed monster. I will also resolve the slow hard disk transfer rate from my external hard disk to this machine, and you can see my solution then. Goodbye and stay safe always.